Hi, let me give you a quick overview of what we saw in today's session. Using Scratch, we will be able to create animations, create games, simply draw over the screen, or even interact with our computer's inputs. We can interact with our mouse, we can interact with the microphone through our audio, or even we can interact with the camera. Using all of these things, we can talk to our computer. And we are also going to create something called as a program so that our program can do all of these things. Now, this Scratch window is divided into three different sections. The first section is the logic section. Divided by this column, all of these are called as logic section. The second area is the program area. In this area, we will be defining our logic, how my application has to behave. The third is the output window, where our actual animation or games takes place. Now, we have picked a one-liner story which we will animate. That's what we did in our session. We had a one-liner story, which is the cat saw the balloon and the balloon flew away. So, what characters are involved in this? Obviously, cat, which is the default character we have in our program. The sprite is the default character. Okay, so an additional input. All objects that we are going to add here are going to be called as sprites. So cat is a sprite, and similarly, many more can be added by selecting this button. So I'm going to add a balloon, which is required for the animation, and that is also called as a sprite. There are many more objects available here. Anything can be added. As per our need, anything can be added. So in this case, let's add a balloon, which is needed now, and I'm going to keep it at the same level of the cat. The third is the background image. It's very much plain. Let's make it colorful. To add a background image, the next button, there is choose a backdrop option. Choose the search button and then select the image what you want. I'm going to select the beach option. Now we have got the plot for our story. In this animation, now the cat has to travel near the balloon and the balloon has to go up. These two are the animations that has to take place. And we are going to define the program for that. Now, programming will be done in Scratch for two separate things. Either it can be for the individual sprites. That is, cat we will program separately, balloon we will program separately. So all the sprites can be programmed individually. Or it will be for the backdrop. The backdrop can also be programmed separately. Now, if I'm going to select cat, you will be able to see here the cat getting selected. So whatever logic I'm going to choose, drag and put it here, this will be applied for my cat. Similarly, if I'm going to choose the next sprite balloon, this will bring up a new window, but we will not be able to see anything for this, right? The reason we have not added anything. So cat's program will be present under that and balloon's program will be present under that. Similarly, backdrop's program will be present under that. First, let me program for the cat alone. The first step what I will be doing in the program is to define when my program has to start. That we will define under the events logic. From the events, I'm going to say when my flag is clicked. We can see our flag here, right? There is a green flag. When I click it, my program should begin. That is marked by the events logic. There are many other logic by which we can start our application or we can start our program. Right now, let's understand the green flag alone. When I'm going to click the green flag, my program starts. And what it should do immediately after starting, my cat has to move till the balloon. So I am going to use the move block here. This can be found under the motion block. From the motion selected, we will be able to see all the motion related blocks. I will drag this move and put it here. Once this is put it, I need to connect it to this first block. Then after this, change the number of steps, because only 300 steps will cause the cat to go near balloon. It needs to walk a certain distance. So 300 I am giving here. Let's see what happens when we click the green flag. When I'm going to click it, if you see here, the cat has moved till this point, right? I'm going to drag it and bring it back, because we have programmed only for cat now. Similarly, we have to program for the balloon to go up as well. Select the balloon, and now there will not be anything. Even for programming the balloon, I am going to make use of the events block. Define when the program has to start. So in this case, I am again going to click the green flag. After clicking the green flag can be clicked only once. For the entire animation, the green flag is clicked only once. Now, immediately after clicking the green flag, I cannot make the balloon to move up. What I should do is, I should wait for the cat to come nearby. For that purpose, I'm going to simply wait here. To simply wait here, we are going to take an option from the control block. Under control block, the first option is wait. Take the wait block and put it here. So under the wait, I am going to ask it to wait for just 1 second, because within a second, the cat moves near the balloon. So I am only going to give 1 second, and after 1 second, how to make the balloon move up? Again, go back to the motion logics. Under the motion logic block, I have an option of change y by 10. I'm going to make use of this block, drag it and put it here. The reason why we are using this to move the balloon, we will understand it tomorrow. Okay, we are reading this like a graph. So do not worry why this block is picked. If you are mathematics, in your mathematics, you would have studied x and y axis. So according to your standard, in your school grade, you would have studied x and y axis. So x axis corresponds to the horizontal direction and y axis corresponds to the vertical direction. And the axis of x and y is at the center 0, 0. So here, if I am going to say change y by say 200, this is the vertical direction. So vertically, I am going to increase the value by 200. That is what change y by 200 stands for. Okay, we will anyway repeat it again, not to worry. So once the green flag is pressed, I am going to wait for 1 second and change the y vertical direction by additional 200 positions. Right, so this is all this involves. Now let's click the green flag and see how the overall program runs. I'm going to click the green flag. If you see here, the cat moved within a second and then the balloon moved up. Right, so this is just a simple animation here. I will stop the video now and we will understand more and see how we can change this into a game as well tomorrow. Thank you, and let's meet again. Bye-bye.